commemorations and events like this one, we keep alive the memory of the 6 million Jews who were murdered during the Holocaust. I was very glad when I visited Israel in July last year to have an opportunity to spend some time at Yad Vashem, where many of these stories are told. It was one of the most powerful experiences in my life as a public representative. We also remember, through this exhibition, individuals who helped to save the lives of those fleeing persecution and murder. One of the things which is clear in this exhibition is that those who saved the lives of others were not always in the most powerful of positions. In fact, often quite the opposite.
The diplomats we honor in our exhibition were people of boundless courage. They utilized the tools they had, the tool of diplomacy, to issue visas, passports, protective letters, and to do anything they could do to help Jews who were fleeing the Nazi terror. Many of them were punished by the foreign ministries, and some had to sacrifice their careers because of their actions. Some died penniless, some disappeared with their fate unknown, but all of them are remembered by us now.
It's a great honor and privilege for me to be here today. First of all, I'd like to pay special tribute to Ambassador of Israel, His Excellency Mr. Boca, and his team for arranging this event, Mr. Chiune Sugihara. He worked in Kaunas, the capital of Lithuania, during the Second World War. As the war broke out, Jewish people seeking a Japanese transit visa surrounded the consulate in Kaunas. Mr. Sugihara made his own decision to issue the transit visas without waiting for permission from the Japanese government. From that point on, until strong orders came from Tokyo for the closing of the consulate, Sugihara continued to issue the visas.
This year, Lithuania celebrates a centenary of the restoration of its independence. Lithuanian Jews fought for our country's independence, and they actively helped to build and strengthen it. Almost 200,000 Lithuanian Jews were murdered during the Holocaust.
It was Isaac Levin, his wife Tesla, Nathan Gurwitz, and his fiancée, just four of the 2,355 Jews whose life was saved by Jan Zwartendijk. Jan Zwartendijk, with the approval of his ambassador, provided them with false visa for the Dutch-controlled Caribbean island and Curaçao. No one intended to go to the Dutch islands, but it was the only way to escape from death.